Jeez, Josh. Once again, brother, you've outdone us all. I can't believe you actually did this.
Don't you guys think this is a little bit cruel?
Oh, come on. She deserves it.
And it's not her fault that she has a huge crush on
him. Hannah's been making the moves on him. I'm just looking out for my girl, Em.
Just because he's class prez doesn't mean he belongs to everyone. Mike is my man.
I am. I'm not anybody's man.
Whatever you say, darling.
Did you see that? Dad said it'd just be us this weekend. Josh. Oh my God. What did our naive sister get herself into now?
Hey, Hannah.
I got your note.
Glad you could make it. Maybe we should start with a little, you know, making out and see where it goes from there.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God. Your shirt off.
Hannah, hey, don't. It's just a stupid prank, okay?
I'm sorry, Hannah. This all got out of hand.
Jerks. You know that? Hannah!
Josh! Fuck!
Hannah!
What's going on? Where's she going?
It's fine. She just can't take a joke.
It was just a prank, Han.
What did you do?
Just messing around, Beth. It wasn't serious.
You jerks!
So, should we go after her?
You know, I kind of think you're the last person she wants to see right now, Mike.
Hannah! Hannah? Damn it, Hannah. Where are you? Hannah. Oh my God, you must be freezing. Here, take my coat. I'm such an idiot. I'm so dumb. Anna, Beth?
Before we begin, there are a few things I need to make sure you understand. You see, no one can change what happened last year. The past is beyond our control. You have to accept this in order to move forward. But there is freedom in this revelation. Everything you do, every decision you make from now on will open doors to the future. I want you to remember this. I want you to remember this as you play your game. Every single choice will affect your fate and the fate of those around you. So, you have committed to commence with this game. This is significant, and I want to help you see it through. Sometimes these things can be a little scary, even terrifying, but I'm here to make sure that no matter how upsetting things may get, you will always find a way to work through it. Hmm? All right. We will start with a simple exercise. Could you please pick up a card? And I want you to look at the picture on the other side and tell me what you feel about it. It is essential that you answer honestly in order to get the most out of this experience. So, how did that picture make you feel? Remember, be honest. Okay, honesty is good. What do you think it is that makes you feel uneasy? Well, I see. Let's see. The scarecrow were not there. Would you feel comfortable staying there on your own for a period of time? Let's say a week, for example. Huh. And what if I told you that this cottage was haunted? So, the scarecrow frightens you, and yet you don't appear to be bothered by the possibility of the supernatural. I suspect that someone is not being entirely honest with me. Our time's up. Let's investigate that in our next session, shall we?
Today is the one-year anniversary of the dreadful tragedy that took place on Mount Washington. Rep. Annie Klein was charged with investigation. Thanks for having me. Listeners, an update on Hannah and Beth Washington, the twins who are still missing.
1 year ago tonight, the Washington girls left the safety of their parents' lodge and headed out into a snowstorm.
Foul play?
Not officially, no. There is one individual we're considering as a person of interest, but his whereabouts are currently unknown. He has an interesting history with the Washington family. He had warned them against pursuing their construction project and claimed the land was sacred to his forefathers.
You know, there is still the old sanatorium on the mountain. Could he be hiding there?
My officers did search the grounds, but the girls themselves couldn't have made it that far.
Something about that mountain seems to breed tragic events.
More than you know, Marty.
Well, thank you for joining us, Anne. With all the Washingtons tonight, our son Josh, on this, the anniversary of the mysterious disappearance of Hannah and Beth Washington.
Well, hello, friends and fans. All right, let's do that again. All right. Well, hello, friends and fans. It's beyond awesome to have you guys all back this year. First off, I gotta say, I'm super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway. So, let me just let you know, let's take a moment to address the elephant in the room for a second. I know you're all probably worried about me, and I know it's gonna be tough on all of us going back after what happened last year, but I just want you all to know, it means so much to me that we're doing this, and that I know it would mean so much to Hannah and Beth that we're all still here together, you know, thinking of them. I really want to spend some quality time with each and every one of you, and just share some moments that we'll never forget for the sake of my sisters, and, you know. Okay, so let's party like we're fucking porn stars, okay? Make this one trip we will never forget, all right? Yes!
Hello? Someone there? What? Damn it. Oh, Jesus, never mind. Hey, little fella. You hungry? Huh? Cutie. Cool. Hello? Wow, graffiti all the way up here. Chris, are you here?
The bag's here, where are you?
You're not in the bag, are you?
Hello. What do we have here? Maybe I should look around Chris's stuff.
Chris?
Sam, hey, you made it. Oh, so, I found something kinda amazing.
What?
I'm not gonna tell you. You gotta see for yourself. Come on, it's this way.
Where?
Right around here. Gonna blow your mind. Ta-da! Pretty rad, right?
Yeah.
Come on, look at these beauties.
Beauties is not the word that comes to mind. Why is this even here?
What do you mean?
What the hell is a shooting range doing at the base of a ski lodge?
Dude, have you ever met Josh's dad?
Yeah.
He thinks he's like Grizzly Adams or something. Wanna try?
No, you go ahead, Grizzly.
All right, here goes. All right, I'm bad. I'm a badass.
I'm gonna go ahead and guess it was a wild case of beginner's luck.
Nah, I don't think so, girl.
Well, anybody and their brother could shoot a bottle that big, that close. Nice shot.
Your ass just got sacked.
Ugh. Hey, sharpshooter, our ride's coming.
Wait, I'm just getting the hang of this.
Come on, Chris, the cable car.
Nice. You think we'll get a visit from America's Most Wanted?
It's like someone thought so.
Oh, come on. This place is abandoned most of the year. Nobody comes up here. Man, it is... It's definitely weird coming back up here after a whole year.
Yeah, I swear, the moment I got here, it just all came flooding back.
The year goes fast.
It must be really hard on Josh.
I don't know how he keeps it all together. I mean, I'd be a wreck.
Well, we're all just gonna have to keep an eye on him. Must be going through so much, and he seems like the kind of guy who's not gonna just ask for help, you know?
Yeah.
Hey, that's weird. Door's locked.
Yeah. Josh wanted us to keep it locked to keep people out.
He said that? What people?
I don't know. He said they found people sleeping in the station one time.
That's creepy.
You?
Oh, real gentleman.
Crazy place to set up house. I mean, no matter how rich you are.
They're not so rich. They only bought a mountain. Huh? And I thought the car was closer.
Guess we gotta wait.
I'm starting to get the appeal of killing time at the shooting range. How long is this gonna take?
It's a big mountain.
Yeah. So beautiful in the day, but at night just feels menacing, like a sleeping giant.
You gonna publish?
What?
Your pretty poem. A sleeping giant of the Blackwood Forest.
Oh, shut up. Finally, you coming?
Yeah, well, I was gonna stay here and catch some seeds, but... Okay. Just like going to the prom.
Here we go.
Right. Adventure begins.
Oh, I hope this was the right thing to do.
What?
You know, getting everyone together on the anniversary. I mean, Josh seemed really pumped about us all doing something, didn't he?
Yeah, no, he definitely did. I haven't seen him so excited about something in forever.
Good, good. It's hard to tell with him, and I know, I've kind of been worried.
No, it was a good idea.
I hope everyone else feels the same way.
We're all here, aren't we?
Thanks, bro, good talk.
You know what, let's just stop talking about what happened and enjoy the trip.
You know what, you're right.
You know how Josh and I met?
No.
Okay. Third grade. Josh sat in the back of the room, I sat in the front. We didn't even know each other existed. But the kid sitting next to Josh started strap snapping the training bra on the girl in front of him. So the teacher made him move to the front, where I was sitting.
Okay, so?
So I got moved to the back.
And
next to Josh. That's how we met. I mean, and became friends to this day.
Match made in heaven.
If it weren't for the fact that Jeannie Simmons hit puberty like 3 years early and on that day decided to wear a low-cut shirt that showed off her training bra, I mean, who knows? You could be riding in this cable car alone. Right now. Or talking to some other person entirely. Boom. Butterfly effect.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. New people. Time to meet and greet.
Oh! What the hell?
Jess, hey!
Jessica, over here! Are you guys having a really weird stroke?
We're stuck in this stupid thing.
Can you please let us out? Pretty please?
Oh my god. I thought we were goners. Another 10 minutes in there and I would have chewed off my own leg.
Oh, sick, Chris.
Look, got a lot of meat on my bones. It's all muscle down here.
Yeah, right.
Hey!
Well, 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 what do we have
Chris.
Here? My goodness. Seems that someone has a little crush on our good friend and dear class president, Michael Monroe.
Chris.
And what kind of sizzling erotica might our Jessica be capable of imagining? I wonder.
Give that back, you tool.
Tool and die. That's my motto.
Oh, you're such an idiot. Maybe nosy Nancy shouldn't go nosing around in other people's nostrils.
Yeah, I try not to do that, as a rule.
Come on, Jess, you can tell us. You can totally keep secrets.
Whatever. You'll figure it out eventually.
All right, let's just get up to the lodge already. It's getting tired of all this nature and junk.
You guys go ahead. I'm just gonna wait here for a bit. See who else is coming.
You mean Mike?
What? I mean, you know, whoever.
Uh-huh. Sam?
Did you see this view? I mean, holy cow. Sometimes I forget to just stop and take it all in.
Seriously, couldn't they have built the lodge like right where the cable car ends?
I don't think it would have been like as pretty, you know?
And where's the bellboy when you need one? Getting chills.
We're almost there.
No, I mean getting kind of creeped out.
Oh, yeah.
Gonna be weird seeing everyone up here again.
Definitely not gonna feel like a regular party. I mean, what do you think?
Jesus!
You guys.
Michael!
You really, really should have seen your faces right there.
Dude, I almost clocked you just now.
Nice one.
Michael, you're a jerk.
Come on. Guys, we're all friends here, right? No need for violence, just a little harmless fun. We're up in the woods, it's spooky. Come on, let's get into the spirit of things.
The spirit of things? Seriously, what's wrong with you?
I was just trying to lighten the mood, Em. Don't be like that.
Like what?
The way you're being. You always get like this.
Michael, I'm just gonna lay it out. Otherwise, this whole weekend's gonna suck ass for everyone. This is super awkward, and we all know it. Let's just acknowledge it now and move on, okay?
Matt.
I hear you, man. I get it. I don't want to make this weird.
Cool. So we're good?
All good.
You guys gonna make out now?
Oh my god, totally. We're so gonna make out. No. Seriously, I'm gonna go check on the cable car back down the trail.
All right. See you, man.
See ya.
All right.
See ya!
Oh, crap.
What?
Hey, could you take these the rest of the way?
The bags?
Yeah. All the bags.
Why?
I need to go find Sam.
Okay.
Sorry, I really need to go find her. I totally forgot I needed to talk to her before we get all the way up there.
This really can't wait. We're almost there.
It's important. Matt, please.
All right. Fine. If it's so important, I guess I can pack horse it the rest of the way. But you owe me one.
Excuse me?
Well, then we're even, at least.
I'll think about it.
Just be careful.
See you up there, sweetie. Thank you.
Whoa, hello. Somebody's getting a little friendly. Not in the friend zone kind of way. They might need to check the expiration date on their big breakup.
Oh! Oh, God. Hey, whoa. Sorry there. Sorry about that, Ash. I didn't mean to scare
Jeez
you.
Louise,
well,
Matt.
I did mean to scare you, sort of scare you, but not like for real scare you.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
Hey, wow. Man, I'm really sorry, Ash. Damn.
It's okay. It's fine. It's fine.
What are you looking at? See anything juicy with that thing? Let me check it out.
Yeah, it's kind of busted. It's not like really interesting. It's just.
What? For real? I bet I could find like a cool bear chowing down on a fox or something.
No, really, Matt, it's not worth straining your eyes. I'm getting kind of a headache just from looking through it, so just no. No.
All right. Sure, if you say so.
You did not just do that.
Put your hands where I can see them. We've got you, sir.
But who am I to retaliate? What choice do I, a supple young rebel girl, have but to surrender to this strapping military guard come to take me into custody?
Well, I don't know when you put it like that. Hey! Oh! Great. Hey, you know that?
Where are you hiding, little chick?
So did I go down?
I don't think so.
I think you'd know so if I did.
All right.
My. So are we calling it my favor then?
Your worthy opponent, Miss Jessica, the Snowball Queen.
Okay, that sounds vaguely dirty.
My lady. Oh, okay, you're really gonna get it.
What am I gonna get?
Well, I can think of at least one thing.
Yeah?
But you'll have to wait until later. We should get up to the lodge.
Yeah, it's so nice out here, though. Pretty breathtaking.
I mean, I could stay out here for pretty much ever, provided I was making out with you the whole time.
Just making out?
Quote, unquote.
Well, I think we might freeze to death somewhere in between those quotes.
Yeah.
Hello again. And how are we feeling? I believe that in our last session, you were not completely honest with me. I'm an expert with years of experience. You don't think you can mislead me? This time, we're going to try to understand the root of your anxiety. Now pick up that book, turn the pages. You will see a set of pictures and symbols. I want you to identify which image in each set makes you the most anxious. Did I startle you? So sorry. You're doing very well. Don't be nervous. Try to speed up a bit. The more you rely on your instincts, the more honest your answers will be, and the more enlightening you will find this experience. Thank you for answering so diligently. Spiders, clowns, and dogs. The sun combination sounds like a good Friday night. Well, I'm afraid once again we're out of time, but I promise we'll talk again very soon.